Okay, thank you. So good evening, everybody. Thank you for attending this last talk for today. So my name is Eric Auger. I work at Red Hat in the virtualization team. And so this talk is about virtual IOMMU implementation in the context of a special use case, so device pass-through. And I'm going to focus especially on one implementation based on hardware nested paging. So first, I will introduce the IOMMU hardware. We will introduce some terminology that we are going to use all over the presentation. Then we will focus on the device pass-through use case, especially we are going to look at Linux and QEMU integration. We will see how the physical IOMMU is used, and then we will add a little more complexity by adding the virtual IOMMU in the picture. We will see that depending on the hardware, we have different implementation choices to implement this virtual IOMMU. And I will detail the integration on at Linux and QEMU level for the system MMU, which is the ARM IOMMU. And I will complete this presentation by status of the work and remaining challenges. So the IOMMU is an hardware block that is put in between a DMA-capable device and the system interconnect. So its job is to translate the DMA requests that are expressed in a given address space into an output address space. And on top of that, it also performs some permission checks on the transactions. So the principle is that the device tags its DMA transaction with a unique ID. On ARM, this is called the stream ID. On Intel, this is the source ID. And this unique ID allows the IOMMU hardware to locate some configuration structures that are usually located in external memory. Those configuration structures tells how the translation needs to be performed. What are the characteristics of the translation? And obviously, it also points to a set of page tables that are located in the external memory. Once the IOMMU hardware has done this configuration lookup, it is actually able to perform the page table work. So it looks first into some caches within the hardware, which are called the IOTLBs. And if there is a miss, we do not find the translation there, so we are obliged to do the page table work in external memory. So now let's have a look at the device assignment process. So first of all, what this use case consists in? So it consists in exposing a physical device to a guest operating system. And the purpose is that the intent is that we want the guest OS to get the ability to interact and program the device as if it were physically attached to it. So with respect to DMA programming, this means that the guest is going to program the DMA register, target address registers, using its own address space, which is the guest physical address. And you want this physical device to be able to reach the wall guest RAM. Somebody in that process needs to map this guest physical address onto the host physical address that backs the guest RAM. And so besides this actual translation, what we want also is to guarantee that the assigned device won't be able to reach any other host physical address. Typically, we do not want it to reach host physical address used by the host system itself, and we don't want it to reach host physical address that backs part of another VM. So this assignment process brings isolation, DMA isolation. Okay. So now if we you stick to the scheme I explained just before, the trouble is that the assigned device is able to reach the whole guest RAM. And in that sense, it can jeopardize the integrity of the guest OS because it can reach any GPA. So what we want on top of that is to restrict the DMA capability of the assigned device to a particular space within the GPA. So this is achieved by adding the virtual IOMMU, so an IOMMU that is exposed to the guest this time. And with that trick, actually, the guest drivers are going to program the assigned device no more in guest physical address, but using a special address space, which is called IO virtual address space. And that way, we are going to restrict the guest physical address that are reachable by the assigned device. And on top of that, it brings a commodity like a scatter-gazer commodity. You are not forced to use contiguous guest physical address. You can use this IOV space. And in the Linux context, this means that as you expose a virtual IOMMU, an IOMMU, you can also use the VFIO PCI driver on the guest. And this is especially useful for two use cases which are important: the DPDK use case, when you want to develop a network stack that uses user space drivers. This relies on the VFIO API. And also, if you want to assign your device several times, so meaning you want to do assignment on your guest, okay? And in that case, you will also use VFIO to achieve that goal. Now, if you look at this picture on the right, you can see now you have two translation stages. So I use this terminology of stage. So if you look at Intel's terminology, they talk about levels, but this is exactly the same. So here we talk about logical stages. The first one is mastered by the guest operating systems. Okay, when it programs the virtual IOMMU, okay, it actually programs the stage one. This is the first stage that translates guest IOVA into guest physical address. And then you have the former translation stage that is programmed by the virtual machine monitor that does the normal device assignment, I would say, and that translates guest physical address into host physical address. So those are logical stages. I do not make any assumption on how it is going to be implemented at hardware level. This is what we are going to see just after. So now let's have a look at the hardware capabilities. Because you have those two logical stages to be implemented. You remember that you have a physical device that you are going to assign to your guest and this physical device is protected by a physical IOMMU. So this means that at some point of time, you need to program the physical IOMMU. And this programming must be consistent with the two logical stages we have seen before. Okay? So at physical level, there are different kinds of hardware implementation. Either the IOMMU can implement a single stage or a single level for Intel. So this is typically used for the scatter-gazer use case, where a guest operating system is going to translate an IO virtual address into a physical address. Okay. Second case is that your hardware can implement still a single stage, but not meant for scatter-gazer, but rather meant for virtualization use case. In that case, it's meant to translate a guest physical address into host physical address. So those are two different stages. The translation process is different for stage one and stage two. You have different configuration structure for each. So it's a choice when you implement your at hardware level to choose either a stage one or a stage two implementation. Okay, and some hardware implement what we call the hardware nested paging mode, which consists in chaining those two translation processes. So you first execute the stage one, and the output of the stage one is input into the stage two. Okay, and this kind of architecture was really devised for the use case we just saw before. So one stage is in principle controlled by the guest operating system, and the other stage is controlled by the hypervisor. Okay. So now we have seen we have two logical stages to be implemented. We have different kinds of hardware implementation. So let's see now what kind of implementation choices we have. So the first case is that your hardware only supports a single stage of translation. So you have two logical stages to map onto this physical stage. So what is done is that the virtual machine monitor is going to trap on each configuration and translation structure updates performed by the guest. Okay, it will do by software the translation of the first stage, so the IOVA to GPA translation. It does that. So it happens in QMU, in the virtual IOMMU device. Okay, then the virtual machine monitor is able to associate the output of this translation to the host physical address that backs the memory. And it combines the two translations in one and programs the physical IOMMU. And this is the actually the mapping that is programmed at the physical level, which is at the bottom. And so this is what happens on the mapping. Now, when the guest destroys a mapping, it sends invalidation commands to clear the IOTLB entries that correspond to this mapping. This is trapped by the virtual machine monitor. And so we invalidate the IOTLB at the physical level. Okay, this is the way it works. Currently, when your hardware only supports one physical stage, and historically, this is the implementation used for x86 DMA remapping integration. So for the implementation of the virtual IOMMU together with VFIO. The problem, the first issue is that it induces quite a huge penalty for use cases which do a lot of map and map and so on, because each time you map something, so you go through this process. You do the translation by software, you do the association between GPA and HPA, program the hardware, so it's very costly. So it's a trouble. So it depends on the use case. Typically, DPDK does not have such kind of dynamic mappings, but whenever you use an actual native Ethernet driver on the guest, he is allocating DMA buffers very frequently, mapping them and so on, so it's very costly. Besides that, so this is an existing implementation, so it perfectly works for Intel together with QMU and Linux VFIO. The trouble is that when we try to reuse this framework for the integration of the virtual ARM IOMMU, which is called the system MMU, it's not possible to reuse this implementation because the system MMU suffers one weakness. The specification does not force invalidation on map. So this means that when the guest is creating new entries in the page tables, there is no way to trap that at a virtual machine monitor level. So the way it works on Intel is that they devise the special mode, which is called the caching mode. And when this bit is exposed by the virtual IOMMU device, this forces the guest driver to invalidate also on map. And this trick does not, is not specified in the ARM system MMU specification. So we cannot reuse that. So we were obliged to look at something else. And this alternative is based on hardware nested paging because the system MMU specification provisions specify this hardware implementation. So this is an implementation choice to implement both stages at physical level. Some platforms won't implement that, but some do. So in that, case, so it is straightforward because you have two logical stages to map onto the two physical stages. So what happens is that one stage is mostly owned by the guest operating system, and the other stage is owned by the virtual machine monitor. Okay. So the principle. So each time the guest operating system is updating its configuration structure, we trap this event at virtual machine monitor level. And we plug the stage one configuration built by the guest operating system. We plug it into the main configuration structure managed by the virtual machine monitor. So the nice thing is that the structures are well isolated on ARM. So on one side, you have the stage one configuration. On the other side, you have the main configuration structure that contains the stage two configuration. And that's well separated. So the main configuration structure, which is called the stream table entry on ARM, is mastered by the virtual machine monitor for security reasons. Because you couldn't have the guest operating system that updates directly this structure, because it could change the mapping assigned to this stream. So now let's see at so the changes needed to integrate this nested mode. So actually, it's a bit surprising because this nested mode is used for MMU for a while, MMU for CPUs, I mean, but for IOMMU it was it has not been enabled yet. So the framework, both at QMU and kernel level, needed to be updated to support that. So the first thing we have to do is each time at QMU level we detect there is a guest RAM region that is added, we need to inform the virtual machine monitor so that it programs the stage two, so the guest physical address to host physical address mapping. So previously, stage two was not used at all, so it was stage one, rather. And it goes through the VFIO PCI IOCTLs, so DMA map. So as I explained previously, each time the guest does some changes to the configuration structure, we need to pass this update, this information to the host kernel so that it can update the main configuration structure and associate the stage one configuration structure programmed by the guest operating system. So we introduce a new IOCTL at VFIO PCI level to do that. Okay, we have to propagate also cache invalidation commands from the guest to the host operating system. We have a special handling for MSIs. I'm going to comment that in the next slide. And since now all the translation is performed at hardware level, so stage one and stage two translation, whenever we detect there is a stage one translation fault at hardware level, we need to propagate this fault up to the guest. So it requires some special mechanics, so both in the IOMMU subsystem and VFIO PCI level to export this information. So you can see that at kernel level, there is impact at VFIO level, at IOMMU subsystem level, and there are some State machine changes requested also in the SMMU driver. At QMU level, there are quite a lot of modifications as well because we modify the existing framework. We need to add some new notifiers each time the QMU system MMU device detects some of those changes. You need to propagate the information to the VFIO PCI device so that it can use the new IOCTLs. Okay, let's talk about MSIs on ARM because it's a bit of a nightmare. So the problem is on most of the platforms, the MSIs are translated by the system MMU. So it's not like on x86 where MSIs use some special address belonging to a special window, the IO epic window. So it's not like that. So they are translated through the system MMU. And the trouble is that historically, VFIO only mapped the guest physical address onto host physical address for RAM. But it didn't specially handle MSI doorbells. So what we added in the past to support MSIs along with PCI pass-through is that the host kernel is responsible for allocating IOVAs so that there is a mapping that exists to reach the host doorbell. Okay, and then it follows the MSI hierarchy routing path. It injects the virtual MSI into the guest. But so it's essential that the device is programmed by the host IOVA to reach the physical doorbell, actually. Now, the problem is that you add another stage, and there is no mapping at stage one that exists and that allows to reach the host, the physical doorbell. On guest side, actually, the guest is also exposed with virtual IOMMU, so it has exactly the same trouble. It needs one guest IOVA to translate into the guest doorbell. But the problem is that both mappings do not match. And so if you do not do anything special, so each time the assigned device will perform an MSI, it will fault at stage one because there is no mapping. So what we need to do practically is that each time there is a mapping that is created by the guest operating system to map its guest doorbell, so the virtual doorbell, using its guest IOVA. So we trap this event and we pass it to the host kernel so that it can reuse the guest IOVA and create a nesting mapping that reaches the physical doorbell. So it's a bit tricky, but so eventually it works. And now the assigned device uses this guest IOVA to go through the two stages. So. So the question is, do we...
VFIO normally shadows the MSIX table. In this case, you use the guest routing table and you do the shadowing for the...
Actually, we still do the shadowing, but... So I would prefer we keep this until the end. Because it will take okay, so I'm done with the MSI handling stuff, and this works. So so what is the current status? So it has been tested on two new generation platforms for ARM servers, so Qualcomm and Cavium platforms. It's still at the state of RFC at both kernel and QMU levels. The problem is that, I explained we had changes at VFIO and IOMMU level at on kernel side, and the APIs we are defining are supposed to be reused for ARM, for VTD, for shared virtual memory use case also on Intel. and ARM as well, and Virtio IOMMU. So we need to define APIs that are generic enough to be reused for all those use cases, and it takes time. And we have not reached stability yet. With respect to performance, so nobody is very clear on the performance we will be able to achieve with this nested stage integration. The problem is that at the stage one level, all the addresses that are used are guest physical addresses. Would it be the addresses of the configuration structure, the page tables, and obviously the output of the stage one? So all that stuff is going to induce some page table walk at stage two, and this will induce more traffic and more TLBs entry being used. And I would like to complete this presentation by two pointers to presentation made last year at KVM Forum. The first one, made by Peter, was about exactly the same use case but on Intel, so using the so-called caching mode. So for you can dig into more details with respect to this use case. Also, a presentation about shared virtual address in KVM. So it's a Connex use case, so more Intel related for this presentation. And you have the pointers to the kernel and QEMU series if you want to test the feature. So thank you for your attention. Okay, so maybe we can come back to to Paolo's question. Okay, so I'm not sure I fully caught your question, but so maybe I can come back to this drawing. Okay, when the IRQ routing setup is made, so the MSI KVM IRQ routing is set up actually. We trap this information about this banding. Okay, we pass this to the host. And we are reusing this guest IOVA instead of the host IOVA that was formerly allocated by the host system. So I'm not sure about your question. So
no, I'm just not sure why. So how it works with the MSIX card? The MSIX card is able now can point there.
I will need to understand the question first.
Okay,
I prefer because it's great. Okay, any other question? Okay, so thank you.